Good morning. Let us first revise once again the DRR and DRRI requirements. Okay. If it is a all India financial institution and banking company, whether listed or unlisted, whether public issue or private placement, DRR and DRRI not required. Second, it is NBFC and HFC. If it is a listed company, public issue, DRR is not required. DRRI is required. Investment is required. Private placement, DRR not required. DRRI required. And if it is an unlisted company, DRR not required. DRRI also not required. So you have to be very careful. And for other companies, listed company, public issue, DRR not required, DRRI required. For private placement, DRR not required, but DRRI required. And if it is an unlisted company, DRR required up to 10% of outstanding debenture, and DRRI required, right? Then yesterday one student asked a good question. When should we make DRRI? DRRI will be made when? When you have to redeem the debenture, suppose on 31st March, then you have to make an investment on 30th April, before 30th April, okay? On or before 30th April. So therefore in some questions we have not passed entry for DRRI at the time of issue of debenture. It will be made when the debenture is due to be redeemed in the next year. Because companies will not invest their money at a very low rate of interest when they have borrowed at a very high rate of interest. Unnecessarily, they will not block their money for 3 to 4 years. Only in the last year they are going to do that. Right? So you can write a note accordingly. But in some of the institute answer, they have made the investment immediately on the allotment itself. That will not be a good business practice. Okay. But yes, from exam point of view, you can do that. Now, I had asked you to solve one question. Try one question as homework. Question number 10. Sencom Limited issued rupees 1,50,000 5% debenture on 30th September 2080, on which interest is payable half yearly on 31st March and 30th September. Interest is payable on two dates, 31st March and 30th September. Rate of interest is 5% and the debenture issued is 1,50,000. Company has the power to purchase debenture in the open market for cancellation thereof. Following purchases were made during the year ended 31st December 2022 and the cancellation were made on the same date. On 31st December 2080, balance in the DRR account was 25,000 and investment made for the purpose of redemption was 20,000. Now, in this question, these are not relevant. Because they have asked us those two accounts where this will not be required. But otherwise the figures given are not correct. Anyway, question is, you have purchased two debenture on 1st March 2082, rupees 25,000, nominal value means face value, and it was purchased for rupees 24,725 ex interest amount. One more purchases. 1st September 2082, rupees 20,000 face value purchased for 20,125 cum interest price. Is it right? Any query? You are required to draw the following accounts up to the date of cancellation. Debenture account, own debenture account. Debenture account and own debenture account. Own debenture means debenture purchased from the market for cancellation. Ignore taxation. So first what I'll do, first I'll prepare one working note 1, purchase of own debenture you've written. Two purchases we have made. Write down, first column write date, interest accrued, date interest accrued. Interest accrued, draw 3 columns, from, to, number of months. Face value you can write before here or after. Okay. Then draw 3 columns, X interest, only this working note, first one. Other working notes are not required. X interest, interest at 5% per annum, cum interest. Only the first working note. On the screen, first working note. Those who have tried as homework will check. Anybody who's tried, check. And help me also. What is the first date of purchase? 1st March 20X2. Only first working note, huh? These two are not required. What is the interest payment date? 31st March and 30th September. 31st March and 30th September. So I'll first draw a timeline to make you understand. The interest was paid on 30th September, then 31st March, again on 30th. These are the dates. First transaction took place here on 1st March 20X2. So you have to compare with the previous interest payment date. The last interest payment date was 30th September of the previous year. So how many months have expired?
Five
months. So first you will calculate interest accrued for 5 months. Second transaction took place on 1st September. So that you compare with previous interest payment date. What was the previous interest payment date? 31st March. How many months? This is also 5 months. In both cases, interest will accrue for 5 months. In both cases, interest will accrue for 5 months. Okay? Both of you, both 5 months, you got it right? Not now, in homework. So start. Because if you get that right, then my job is easy. So interest accrued from which date to which date you will write? 1st October 20X1. 1st October 202. 1st March 20X2. 5 months. Is right. And what is the face value? 25,000. What is the purchase price? 24725. X interest? 24725 X interest. This time we have to convert into cum interest. Anybody interest? 521. 521. Take 25,000 इंटू 5% इंटू 5/12 521. सो वॉट इज द कम इंटरेस्ट प्राइस फॉर दिस? 25,246. इज राइट 25,246. ओके वन मोर. नेक्स्ट परचेज वॉज मेड ऑन 1st September 2022. So interest will start accruing from which date to which date? 1st April. 1st April 2022. And interest will accrue up to 1st September 2022. Number of months? 5 months. And this time it was purchased on come interest basis. Face value is 20,000. Purchase for 20,125. So you have to compute interest on, take your calculator, 20,000 into 5% into 5/12. 417. So what is the X interest price here? Balancing figure, move backward. Minus 417. 19708. 19708. Is it right? So which two accounts they have asked you to prepare? Write down. Debenture account, write down. Debenture account. Five % debenture account. Draw the format. And second account, about 10 lines keep blank, 8 lines or 10 lines. Second account they have asked you, own debenture investment account. Own debenture investment account, right? Own debenture investment account. Just two accounts. So first we'll start with 5% debenture account. Our current financial year is 2000 X2. So here I will write 20 X2 January 1st, by balance brought down. By balance brought down 1,50,000. This is the opening balance of this year. Then in this year, there is a purchase of own debenture. How much? 1st March 2000 X2, face value is 25,000, X interest price is 24725, an interest account we are not preparing. So only what is relevant for us is the X interest amount. Entry will be own debenture account debit, interest account debit to bank, but we are only interested in X interest amount. So you come to own debenture investment account debit side. Date write down 1st March 20X2 to bank account. What was that amount? 24725. एंड इट वॉज कैंसल्ड इमीडिएटली, इट वॉज कैंसल्ड. सो द एंट्री फॉर कैंसलेशन विल बी 5% डिबेंचर अकाउंट डेबिट टू ओन डिबेंचर अकाउंट. सो राइट डाउन डेबिट साइड डिबेंचर अकाउंट, फर्स्ट पास एंट्री मेंटली एंड देन पुट इट इन टू द लेजर. 1st March 2022, 5% डिबेंचर अकाउंट डेबिट टू ओन डिबेंचर अकाउंट, टू ओन डिबेंचर अकाउंट. व्हाट इज द फेस वैल्यू? 25,000. ओन डिबेंचर अकाउंट क्रेडिट साइड, ओके, 2022 बाय 5% डिबेंचर अकाउंट ट्वेंटी फाइव थाउजेंड. इज देर एनी प्रॉफिट ऑन कैंसिलेशन? सो राइट ऑन द डेबिट साइड 1st March 2022, टू प्रॉफिट ऑन कैंसिलेशन, टू प्रॉफिट ऑन कैंसिलेशन 200 एंड हाँ, डोंट क्लोज इट. There is one more transaction. To profit on cancellation 275. Then one more purchase took place on 1st September 2022 to bank account. To bank account. What is the X interest price? 19708. 19708 is right. Say yes. And then cancellation entry will be 5% debenture account debit to own debenture account, to own debenture account. What is the face value? 20,000. And own debenture account 1st September 2022 by 5% debenture account 20,000. And then you write down to profit on cancellation. To profit on cancellation, how much? 292. To profit on cancellation, 292. Is it telling now? What will you do with this 5% debenture account? You will close. At the end of the year, you will write 31st December 2022 to balance. Carry it down. So what is the balance left in that account? 1,05,000. Total 1,50,000. Total 1,50,000. Take total of this own debenture investment account also. 45,000. Is it 45,000? Done. Any query on that? Whatever they asked, according to that we have solved. Okay. So they have not asked DRR account, DRR investment account, interest account. So those were not prepared. If they ask you, then you will prepare those accounts also. So in some question, we'll draw all the accounts like this problem. Question number next, 11 number. The following balances appeared in the books of Paradise Limited. on 1st April 2061. So these are opening balances you will write in respective account. So when you will draw debenture account, you will write buy balance brought down 7,50,000. When you will draw this DRR account, you will write buy balance brought down 25,000. Right. Now in this question it seems your DRR balance is less than 10%. 10% of 7,50,000. 75,000, but the balance they have maintained so far is only 25,000. So you need to create additional DRR of 50,000. Okay. What about investment? Take 7,50,000 into 15%. This is correct. So we don't have to make any more additional DRR investment. Represented by 10%, rupees 125 secured bond of the Government of India of rupees 100 each. So you should remove this rupees here. This is number of Government of India bonds and this is the face value. So when you multiply, you'll get 1,12,500 on which you will get interest at the rate of 10%. Okay. Next is annual contribution to DRR was made on 31st March every year. So this company is making contribution to DRR account. But 50,000 is still waiting for you. Okay, 25,000 they have done, 50,000 is pending. On 31st March 2062, balance in bank account was 7,50,000 before receipt of interest. Before receipt of interest means you have to pass entry for interest received on investment. Investments were realized at par for redemption of debenture at a premium of 10% on the above date. So at what rate debenture will be redeemed? 10% premium. Debenture will be redeemed at a premium of 10%. Question is, you are required to prepare the following accounts for year ended 31st March 2062. Debenture account, DRR account, DRR investment account, bank account and debenture holders account. Is it right? So first you draw these accounts. Again in this question only last year transaction they have asked. Only last year. What action will happen in last year? They have asked you. So write down 12% debenture account, 12% debenture account, 5 lines, DRR account, about 6 lines, DRR account, 6 lines, then DRR investment account, DRR investment account, DRR investment account again 5 to 6 lines, and then you draw debenture holder account 6 lines. Bank account, 7 or 8 lines, bank account, 5 accounts they have asked you. So last year entries they usually ask, and you have to draw usually 5 to 6 accounts. They could have also asked you interest on DRR investment account. Is it right? डन, फाइव फॉर्मेट्स, सो नाउ विल स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट विल राइट द बैलेंसेस. फर्स्ट विल राइट द बैलेंसेस. डिबेंचर अकाउंट 1st April 20X1. बाई बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन. बाई बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन 7,50,000. एंड अगेन 1st April 20X1. DRR account by balance brought down 25,000. And in DRR investment account 1420X1 by balance brought, sorry, two balance brought down 1420X1. It's an investment account, two balance brought down 1,12,500. What we'll do in DRR account, we'll transfer 50,000 more. Entry, profit and loss account debit to DRR account. So write down in DRR account 1420X1. This is the year of redemption. So I will transfer at the beginning only 20X1 by P&L account 50,000. Calculation right inside the bracket 10% of 7,50,000 minus 25,000. So that is 50,000. Okay. And they have given you balance in bank account on 31st March 2002. So come to this bank account. In bank account 31st March 2002. Means last day of the year, before the redemption started, this was the balance. So therefore bank balance is given at the end of the year. Other balances are given at the beginning of the year. Now all entries will be on 31st March 20X2. Right, keep question in front of you. The question says the following balances appeared in the books of Paradise Limited on 1420X1. 12% debenture account, 7,50,000 we have done. Balance in DRR account 25,000 rupees we have done. DRR investment account 1,12,500 done. But what is the interest rate on that? 10%. So keep that in mind. Annual contribution to DRR was made on 31st March every year. But this is the last year of redemption. So we will pass entry on 1st April only. No problem. On 31st March 20X2 balance at bank was 7,50,000 before receipt of interest. Before receipt of. So what is the entry for interest on DRR investment? Bank account debit to interest on DRR investment. So go to bank account, write down date 31st March 20X2 to interest on DRR investment. how much? You will write 10% of 112,500, 11,250. Now this question is not clear whether this balance is after paying interest on 12% debenture or not. If you assume it is before paying interest on debenture, then you have to pass an entry for interest on debenture also. If you assume it is after paying interest on debenture, then no need to pass the entry for interest on debenture. So what we will assume? After. Because what was not done, they have mentioned. Means other than that, every entry that is required has been passed. Okay. So now we'll sell this investment. What is the value of the investment made? 112,500. Check in the question. Investments were realized at par. So no profit, no loss. Entry. Bank account debit to DRR investment account. So again come to bank account. Same date write down. Same date write down. To DRR investment, 112,500, and then we'll go to this DRR investment account, 31st March 2022, by bank account, sale, 112,000, take total, it will close, 112,500. Then we have to redeem the debenture at a premium of 10%. So we have to pass an entry for premium. What will be the entry? Entry for premium payable on debenture. Securities premium account debit to premium payable on redemption of debenture. Are we preparing securities premium account? Are we preparing premium payable on redemption of debenture account? No. And when, where will this premium payable on redemption of debenture be transferred to? Debenture holder account. So the next entry you visualize, premium payable on redemption of debenture account debit to debenture holder account. To debenture holder account. So write down here, 31st March 2022 by premium on redemption of debenture, by premium on redemption of debenture. How much will be the premium? 75,000. 10% of 750,000. Then we'll pass an entry for transferring the balance of debenture account to debenture holder account. Entry, debenture account debit to debenture holder account. So right here, by 12% debenture account, by 12% debenture account, 7,50,000. Go to debenture account also, debit side of debenture account, 31st March 2022, to debenture holder account. $7,50,000. Close this account. Take total of both sides. Now pay the debenture holder. Entry for payment to debenture holder will be debenture holder account to bank. So write down date 31st March 20X2 to bank. Total amount payable is how much? 8,25,000, including premium. Take total of both sides, 8,25,000. Go to bank account below. In bank account credit side, 31st March 20X2 by debenture holder account. By debenture holder's account, 8,25,000. And again write 31st March 20X2 by balance carried down. By balance carried down. Take first debit side total. How much is debit side total? 8,73,750. Minus 8,25,000. Check the answer. Is it right? 48750.
Yes.
Write total on both sides. So debenture holder account closed. Bank account closed. Debenture account closed. Debenture redemption reserve investment account closed. Then what is not yet closed? Which account is not yet closed? DRR account. How do you close it? Transfer to general reserve. 31st March 20X1 to general reserve 75,000. Write one note at the end of the answer. It is assumed that the bank balance on 31st March 20X2 is after payment of debenture interest. It is assumed that bank balance on 31st March 20X2 is after payment of debenture interest. This answer is over. Any query on this? So these are the questions they will ask you in the exam for 8 to 10 marks. Now we'll go to question number 12. Again, a very important question number 12. The summarized balance sheet of B Company Limited. B. Now they have mentioned here, it's an unlisted company. Other than All India Financial Institution, Banking Company, NBFC and Housing Finance Company. So you'll have to create. Such sentences means you are given a hint that you have to create 10% DRR and 15% DRR investment before redeeming the debenture. Okay. On 31st March, 20X1 is as under. So you are given a balance sheet of a company on this date. They will give you balance sheet in any format. You have to prepare in schedule 3 format. Okay. Share capital authorized. 30,000 equity share of 10 rupees each. 3 lakh. Then issued and subscribed. Right now 20,000 equity share of 10 each fully paid 2 lakh, P&L account balance 1,20,000, 12% debenture 1,20,000 and trade payable 1,15,000. ठीक है? Property, stock, debtor, cash, bank. In the annual general meeting, it was resolved to give existing shareholder द ऑप्शन टू परचेज 1 rupees 10 share एट ₹15 फॉर एवरी 4 shares held prior to bonus distribution. This option being taken up by all shareholders. So what is the number of shares that will be issued here? 1 share for every 4 share held. Go to balance sheet. There are 20,000 shares. 1:4. 1 share for every 4 share held. How many shares will be issued? 5,000 shares will be issued. At what rate? 15. Okay, 1/4 × 20,000. So they are going to issue 5,000 shares at the rate of, this kind of issue of share is called right issue. It is called right issue, which is one of the chapters in your syllabus. Shares issued to existing shareholder. Shares issued to existing shareholder for a consideration. Shares issued to existing shareholder for a consideration is right issue. So this is a normal entry for issue of share, which you have learnt in 11, 12, CPT, Foundation, BCom, PhD. Next line. To issue one bonus share for every 5 share held. To issue one bonus share for every 5 share held. Okay. So how many bonus share will be issued? There are already 20,000 share in the company. Plus you have issued 5,000 share. So now it has become 25,000 into 1/5. 5,000. Bonus shares will be issued at par. Means rupees 10. Bonus share is not issued at a premium. It is issued at par. What is the difference between right share and bonus share? Bonus shares are issued free of cost. Right shares are issued for a consideration. Bonus shares are issued free of cost. Then if you have to issue free of cost, you have to debit some reserve and credit the share capital. Debit the reserve and credit the share capital. Right? These two entries they have asked you, which is not related to this chapter. But in your syllabus, you have right share, bonus share, schedule 3. So it is a combo offer, okay, of 4 chapters. Which 4 chapters? Schedule 3, because you have to prepare the balance sheet, right share, bonus share, and this present chapter, debenture. So in whichever chapter you will study, you have to know the other 3 chapters also. And then the next is to repay the debenture at a premium of 3%. But do we have DRR in the balance sheet? Do we have DRR in the balance sheet? No. Do we have DRR investment in the balance sheet? No. And it is an unlisted other than AIFI banking, NBFC, HFC company. So before we redeem, we'll first create DRR. We'll make DRR investment. And we'll also sell the DRR investment, realize cash and redeem the debentures. Debentures are redeemable at a premium of 3%. Go to balance sheet. 1,20,000 is the face value. So the premium payable on redemption will be 3,600. Is right? Premium payable on redemption will be 3,600. Total amount payable will be how much? If I ask you, total amount payable will be 1,23,000. That will be the entry at the end. Okay. So keep these numbers in mind. You have to issue right share of 75,000 rupees. We have to issue bonus share of 50,000 rupees. Then we have to create DRR 10% of 1,20,000, which is 12,000. We have to make DRR investment, which is 15% of 1,20,000. that is 18,000. We have to pay premium of 3%, that is 3,600. ठीक है, सारे नंबर्स बैठ गए दिमाग में? क्वेश्चन क्या है? व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? गिव द अननेसेसरी जर्नल एंट्री, सॉरी नेसेसरी, ओ एंड प्रिपेयर बैलेंस शीट आफ्टर दिस ट्रांजेक्शन्स आर कंप्लीटेड. सो दिस टाइम यू हैव टू आल्सो प्रिपेयर अ बैलेंस शीट. सो एज आई सेड, दिस क्वेश्चन हैज फोर चैप्टर्स विच आर देयर इन योर सिलेबस. सो नाउ फर्स्ट यू राइट डाउन जर्नल एंट्रीज. जर्नल एंट्रीज आर वेरी इजी. ड्रॉ द फॉर्मेट वन फुल पेज. ड्रॉ द फॉर्मेट वन फुल पेज इन द बुक्स ऑफ बी कंपनी लिमिटेड. जर्नल एंट्रीज वन फुल पेज. नेक्स्ट पेज ऑल्सो टू पेजेस. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बिकॉज इट कवर्स फोर चैप्टर्स. टू पेजेस आई विल रिक्वायर, फुल पेजेस. ड्रॉ द फॉर्मेट डेट पर्टिकुलर्स डेबिट क्रेडिट. डेट कॉलम यू जस्ट कीप ब्लैंक बिकॉज एग्जैक्ट डेट ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन इज नॉट नोन टू अस. इज इट राइट? इट्स नॉट दैट ऑल ट्रांजेक्शन विल टेक प्लेस ऑन वन डे ओनली. दे विल ऑकर एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. सो देयर फोर यू कैन कीप द डेट कॉलम ब्लैंक. फर्स्ट एंट्री गो सिक्वेंशियली, गो लाइन बाय लाइन. First, we are going to issue shares to existing shareholder for cash. How much cash? They will charge 15 rupees. How many shares they will issue? 5,000. 5,000 into 15. Bank account debit. Right, bank account debit. 75,000. Narration you will write very briefly, okay? So bank account debit 75,000. In bracket write calculation 5,000 into 15. 2. Equity share application account. Equity share application account. To equity share application account 75,000. To equity share application account 75,000. Narration right, being application money received. On 5,000 shares. Being application money received on 5,000 shares. At the rate of rupees 15 per share. At the rate of rupees 15 per share, to be issued as right shares in the ratio of 1:4, to be issued as right share in the ratio of 1:4, to be issued as right share in the ratio of 1:4. And then you can show one more calculation here, 1/4 into 20,000 equal to 5,000 shares. Right, all calculation I have disclosed. How 5,000 shares have come? 1/4 into 20,000. And how this 75,000 has come? 5,000 into 15. Second entry, can you pass the second entry? You have to allot the shares. On your own. Write down whatever you have learned. Whatever you have learnt in accounts on allotment of share, check the answer now. Done? Without being how you are checking. First you will write, then you will check. you are going to write this entry. Now you can check. Equity share application account debit 75,000. Equity share application account debit 75,000. To equity share capital account, how much you have written? 50,000 or 75,000? 5,000 into 10, face value. And what about remaining 5 rupees? 5,000 into 5 will go to securities premium. Who got it right? What about others? Wrong. So tell me honestly, how many of you transferred entire 75,000 to share capital account? Was there anybody? Nobody. Impossible. One honest person said yes. And how many you written to bank on the credit side 75,000? Tell me honestly. Come on. Nobody. That's good. So you should know that if face value is 10, anything above face value will be transferred to securities premium. Write a small narration. Share application money. Share application money. Share application money on 5,000 shares at rupees 10 per share. At rupees 10 per share, transferred to share capital account, and rupees 5 per share to securities premium account. And rupees 5 per share to securities premium account. Suppose you don't have time, you can just write on being allotment of shares. Okay. If you don't have time in the exam, being allotment of shares. If you have more time, write this much. Now my next question is adjustment number B. To issue one bonus share for every 5 share held. After this entry, the number of shares have become 25,000. Okay. So we will assume that bonus share will be issued on 25,000 share. So number of bonus share issued will become 1/5 into 25,000 is 5,000. For 5,000 bonus share, you need to transfer 5,010, don't write, we'll write it neatly. You need to transfer 50,000 rupees to share capital. So what will be the source of 50,000? Source will be reserve. Which reserve we will use? Which reserve we can use? Right now we have only two reserve. Right now we have only securities premium, we have 25,000. And P&L account we have 1,20,000. Can I use securities premium for bonus share?
Yes.
Yes. So I will transfer from securities premium 25,000. Companies Act says you can use securities premium to issue bonus share. And then we don't have any other choice now. We have to debit 25,000 to P&L account. Because securities premium have only 25,000 rupees and we don't have other reserve. Do we have any other reserve in the balance sheet right now? No. So you will debit this account first, then this account. Okay. Securities premium account has limited usage. So therefore we'll first try to use securities premium. P&L account is a free reserve. So normally companies will keep free reserve free. Okay, so that in future you can use it for any other purpose also. So therefore my entry will be securities premium account debit 25,000. Securities premium account debit 25,000. This is created when you issued the right share. P&L account debit 25,000. P&L account debit 25,000. I need total 50,000. So I have to use 25,000 from P&L account. To bonus to shareholder, 50,000. 5,000 shares into rupees 10. Then you write down one small narration for understanding. Amount transferred for issue of bonus shares, amount transferred for issue of bonus shares to existing shareholders. Amount transferred for issue of bonus shares to existing shareholders in the ratio of 1:5. And then you write the calculation here. 1/5 into bracket 20,000 plus 5,000. So that is how this 5,000 shares have come. Now this account, bonus to shareholder account, will be converted into equity share capital account. So we don't pass the entry directly. First we create a provision and then we transfer it to share capital. So the next entry will be bonus to shareholder account debit. Bonus to shareholder account debit to equity share capital account. Bonus to shareholder account debit to equity share capital account. 50,000. So your share capital has increased by 50,000. Your share capital has increased by 50,000. So this is adjustment number B. First two adjustment has nothing to do with this chapter, redemption of debenture. Now the third adjustment is related to redemption of debenture. To repay the debenture at a premium of 3%. First check in the balance sheet. Is there any DRR there? Has the company created any DRR? Has the company made any DRR investment? No. So I have to first do that exercise because it is an unlisted company. So we'll write down one entry for creation of DRR. P&L account debit 12,000. P&L account debit 12,000. To DRR account 12,000. How this 12,000 has come? In bracket write down. Being DRR created into bracket again 10% of 1,20,000. Being DRR created 10% of 1,20,000. And then you are also going to make an investment. You are also going to make an investment. Being DRR created 10% of 1,20,000. Now write down DRR investment account debit. You have to make investment. Put your money in some deposit or some government security. Okay. Up to how much? Minimum 15%, you can say. So that will come to 18,000. 15% of 1,20,000. Debenture redemption reserve investment account debit 18,000 to bank account 18,000. How this 18,000 was arrived at? 18,000 kaise aaya? 15% of 1,20,000. Narration being DRR investment created. Any query? Now what you'll do? DRR we have created, this investment we have made. Now we'll pass entry for premium payable on redemption of debenture. Tell me which account I will debit, securities premium or P&L account? Not securities premium. Why? No balance. No balance left. Is it right? No balance left. So therefore we are going to debit P&L account. If there was balance, then we would have debited securities premium. Okay. So the next entry will be P&L account debit 3600 to premium payable on redemption account. To premium payable on redemption account 3600. To premium payable on redemption account 3600. To premium payable on redemption account 3600. Narration right. Being premium payable on redemption charged to profit and loss account. Premium payable on redemption charged to P&L account. What will be the next entry? Total amount due to debenture holder entry. So the entry would be 12% debenture account debit 1,20,000. Total amount due entry first, then payment. Premium payable on redemption of debenture account debit. Premium payable on redemption of debenture account debit 3600. Calculation done already. To debenture holder account 1,23,600. Right? Being total amount payable to debenture holders. Then make the payment. But do you have money to make the payment? So what we should do, before we make the payment, sell the investment. Sell the investment and raise money. Bank account debit 18,000. To DRR investment account 18,000. It is better first you sell the investment, then redeem the debenture. You need first cash. Okay. Narration right. Being DRR investment realized. Now you can redeem the debenture. Write down. Debenture holder account debit to bank account. Debenture holder to bank 1,23,600. Is it right? 1,23,600. 1,23,600. Yes. Any more entry do you think is pending? You have created DRR. That DRR needs to be transferred to general reserve. Is it right? Because we have redeemed the debenture. So the next entry will be DRR account debit to general reserve. DRR account debit to general reserve. Being DRR balance transferred to general reserve. All entries are over now. Now you have to prepare balance sheet in Schedule 3 format. So you write down this balance sheet format first. then we'll decide the amount. Keep the question in front of you. Same balance sheet converted into Schedule 3 format. So you will write balance sheet of B Company Limited. Balance sheet of BEE, B Company Limited, as on. Date is not known when this entire process was completed. So only write in bracket after completion of transactions. Exact date is not known. After completion of transactions. And then you draw the format first. Particulars. Serial number, particulars, note number, rupees. Serial number, particulars, note number, rupees. Was it there in your earlier syllabus? Yes. Foundation. Format of Schedule 3. That's it. So first you write down equity and liabilities. Write down equity and liabilities. Under equity and liabilities, one, shareholders' funds. You have to follow the format. One, shareholders' funds. Under shareholders' funds, write down A, share capital. Under shareholders' funds, write down A, share capital. B, reserves and surplus. B, reserves and surplus. Note number 1, note number 2. All details will be written in note number 1 and note number 2. Point number 2, write down current liabilities. Which item in the given balance sheet will come under current liability? You will see there is a last item, trade payable, in the balance sheet given to you. So trade payable will come under which heading? Current liabilities. So write down trade payable, one line blank, total. One line blank, part 2 assets. Under assets, I'd write one, non-current asset. Under non-current asset, write A, property, plant and equipment. Property, plant and equipment. Then under that, write down tangible asset. Then under that, write down freehold property. Freehold property. One line blank. Point number 2, write current assets. Point number 2, current assets. In current assets, you write down in your question book, you are given stock. So stock will be written as inventories in the balance sheet. We don't write stock, we'll write inventories. Then you write down trade receivable. Trade receivable. And third heading, write down cash and cash equivalent. A small correction here. Cash equivalent. Write note number 3. We'll prepare a note number 3 for that. Note number 3, then write total. Write total. Okay. So the same format given to you is converted into a Schedule 3 format. Very easy. And now we'll write below this balance sheet, note number 1. First write notes to accounts. Notes to accounts. Note number 1, share capital. So you write note number here, note number 1, particulars, rupees. You have to write in proper format because now you are under law, Companies Act. Okay. Share capital authorized. Do we have authorized capital in this question? Yes. How much? Is it 30,000? So can I write here 30,000? Authorized means registered capital. 30,000 equity shares. 30,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each. This is my authorized or registered capital, 3 lakh. And then you double underline. Not to be considered in total, only for disclosure. This is the capital the company can raise as per memorandum of association. Then below that write issued, subscribed and paid up. Issued, subscribed and paid up. If issued, subscribed and paid up are equal, we can write in one line. If they are different, separate line. So how many shares are issued, subscribed and paid up? So for your information, earlier we had 20,000 share. 5,000 right shares were issued. 5,000 bonus shares were issued. So those who want to write, you can write later. Oh, this 30,000 has come. So 30,000 is because we have issued 5,000 right share and bonus shares. So 30,000 equity share of rupees 10 is fully paid up. Written, what will be the amount? 3 lakh. Then you write, out of above, 5,000 share. You have to write a note when you issue bonus share. You have to write a note when you issue a bonus share. Out of above, 5,000 shares of rupees 10 each, fully paid, issued as bonus shares. Issued as bonus share. Schedule 3 requires that company will disclose shares issued as bonus share in the notes. Okay. So go to the main page now. In the main page, share capital. How much will you write? 3 lakh. So write 3 lakh. Share capital 3 lakh. What about reserve and surplus? Write down below note number 2 now. If I ask you to answer, what will be the total balance of reserve and surplus? Total balance of reserve and surplus. Can you answer? Test your understanding and give me the answer of reserve and surplus total. Only total. Final figure. Only final figure. 91,400. Is it 91,400? 12,000. 12,000, 91,400, 91,400, 95,000, 95,000. Bolo. Answer. 91,400. Okay, let us check. First you write down, note number 2 you have written here, reserve and surplus, underline. Which are the reserve which will appear in our balance sheet now? P&L account will appear. P&L account will appear. How much? First write opening balance. P&L account opening balance was how much? Anybody? 120,000. We have to now go through all our journal entries. You have passed so many journal entries today. Check when have you debited, when have you credited in P&L account, starting from first entry. So we have used P&L account for premium on redemption of debenture. Debit kiya tha, kam hoga, you have debited, reduce. Less premium on redemption of debenture. How much? 3,600, correct. Less utilization for issue of bonus share. Less utilization for issue of bonus share. Anybody? 25,000. In your third entry, you have debited P&L account 25,000. In somewhere fourth or fifth entry, you have debited P&L account, created DRR, less DRR created. How much? Was it 12,000? So what is the final balance left in P&L account? 79,400. Then you write B, general reserve. Do we have any opening balance of general reserve? No. Opening balance zero. But we have transferred from DRR. Add transfer from DRR. How much? Last entry. 12,000? 12,000. What about securities premium? What about securities premium? It was transferred to bonus share, right? So balance left is zero. You want to write or let it be? Let it be. Otherwise, you can write that also. So tell me the total now. Securities premium was debited by 25,000. Credited also 25,000. So the balance is zero. If you want to present, you can present that also. So come to the main page. Any query on this? Go through all your entries. P&L account debit we have done three times, so it will reduce three times. General reserve we have credited once. Main page. Reserve and surplus 91. Total of shareholder fund in the outer column 391. Trade payable, no adjustment in trade payable, same figure, 1 lakh. What about debenture? Will it not be written in the balance sheet? Debenture is redeemed. So tell me the total of this liability side. 5 lakh. 6,000. 400. Right? Okay, come to freehold property. Same figure. Because we have not done any entry, any adjustment in this account. Unless you pass some entry, the account balance will not change. What about inventory? Same? Same. First column here. 1,35,000. No adjustment. Trade receivable, same? 75,000. For cash and cash equivalent, we'll prepare a note. Okay, okay. Write a note number 3. Note number 3. Cash and cash equivalents. So under that we have two items. A, cash. Cash in hand. Cash in hand will not change. 30,000. But cash at bank, balance at bank will change. So how much will be the bank balance now? Anybody who can guess? So type on your calculator first 2 lakh, which is the opening balance, plus you have issued right share and you got 75,000, and then you redeemed the debenture 123,600. You made the investment, you redeemed the investment, so that will not affect balance. Or you want to write that also, plus 18 minus 18. No. What is the balance left now, anybody? 1 lakh? 51,400. So what is the total? I have not mentioned here that investment in DRR made and investment in DRR realized, because it won't affect my answer. First you invested 18,000, then you redeemed 18,000. So you want to write, you can write, otherwise leave it. So we'll go back to main page, current asset, write 181,400. Total of current asset, 3 lakh. Total of asset side, tallied, enjoy. Write one assumption and then we'll close this answer. It is assumed that bonus share will be made on, it is assumed that bonus share will be made on right shares also. Bonus shares will be made on right shares also. Bonus shares will be made on right shares also. Normally you will assume that. Okay, if bonus share is given to you after the right share adjustment, you can assume bonus share will be made on right share also, but you have to write a note, because it depends on company's resolution. Some companies may not give bonus share on right issue. Accordingly, you have to solve the problem. Now we'll go to question number 13. Question number 13. Again, one very, very important question for not less than 12 marks. Not less than 12. This time also we'll have to prepare a balance sheet. The summarized balance sheet of Convertible Limited, unlisted company other than AIFI Banking Company, NBFC, HFC. So if this sentence is given, so they are asking you to create 10% DRR and 15% DRRI. And this balance sheet date is 30th June 2021, stood as follows. This time they have given you a balance sheet in the vertical format, but this again you have to convert into Schedule 3 format. It's not proper Schedule 3. Share capital right now is 5 lakh share of rupees 10 each fully paid, 50 lakh. General reserve, this time there is some general reserve. P&L account is there. Tick tock. Debenture redemption reserve. Debenture already there. So don't further create if it is sufficient. 13.5% convertible debenture, 1 lakh debenture of rupees 100 each, 1 crore. Let us check immediately whether this DRR is 10% of 1 crore. Yes, sufficient. Will you pass entry for DRR creation? Already done. Then why you did in the previous problem? It was not there. It was not there. Now it is there. Understand the difference. Problem is same, but it is little different also. DRR is already there in the balance sheet. In problem before that, it was only 25,000. I had to create additional 50. So this way they will give you full DRR is there, zero DRR is there, some DRR is there, some you have to create. Understood? Other loans. This will just go to balance sheet. No adjustment. Current liabilities, no adjustment. Total asset side, fixed asset. DRR investment, 15 lakh. Tick, tick. This means this company has already created DRR investment. Is it equal to 15% of 1 crore?
Yes.
Sufficient? Only will sell it and realize cash. Cash and bank balance, other current asset total. So this time we will not create DRR. We will not invest in DRR investment. But after the debentures are redeemed, we will transfer to general reserve and will redeem the investment. The debentures are due for redemption on 1st July 2021. The terms of the issue of debenture provided that they were redeemable at a premium of 5%. So, what is the total value of debenture in the balance sheet? 1 crore. Add 5% premium to that. 1 crore plus 5%. We have to pay 1 crore 5 lakhs. And also conferred option to the debenture holders to convert 20% of their holding. Those who want, they can convert 20% of their holding into equity share. Not 100%, 20%. So if you are holding 100 debenture, you can convert 20 debenture into equity share at a predetermined price of 15.75 per share. Okay. So if you want to convert debenture into equity share, the equity share will be issued at 15.75. So how will you calculate number of equity share to be issued? First you will calculate what is the value of debenture which will get converted into equity share, divide by 15.75. Divide by 15 point, that will give you number of equity shares to be issued. One problem we had done earlier, 2 days before, only on number, right? Exactly same treatment. Those who don't want share, enjoy cash. In any case, cash will have to be paid because you can't convert all your debenture into shares. Only 20% you can convert into shares. So cash will be paid for the remaining. Assume, except for 100 debenture holder holding totally 25,000 debentures, the rest of them exercise the option for maximum conversion. So how many of the debenture holder did not exercise conversion option? Those who are holding 25,000 debenture, they did not exercise conversion option. But those who are holding 75,000 debenture, those who are holding, they have decided to convert into equity share to the maximum extent allowed. Now understand this paragraph because your whole answer depends on this. In the balance sheet, if you see, we have 1 lakh debenture. We'll write it neatly later. Only understand, 25,000 debentures did not convert into share. Only 75,000 converted into share. Those who will convert will get 20%. Means 15,000. Ultimately 15,000 will get converted into share. And they will be paid at 105 rupees. They will be paid at 105. So the amount payable on this 15,000 debenture is 15,75,000. Don't write. We will do it neatly. and the issue price of equity share is 15.75. So the number of equity share to be issued, 1 lakh. Number of equity share to be issued will be 1 lakh. Once again, total debenture in the balance sheet, 1 lakh. 25,000 debenture straightforward said, we don't want any share, ignore them. Those who are remaining, they have decided to convert whatever maximum they can convert into equity share. They are given option to convert only 20% of their holding, not 100%. So into 20%, means out of 75,000 debenture, 15,000 will be converted into equity share. And the amount payable per debenture is 105. So amount payable on 15,000 debenture is 15,75,000. So instead of paying this amount, they are issuing share. Each share is of 15.75. So therefore, to calculate the number of share, we'll take 15,75,000 divided by 15.75. It comes to 1 lakh shares. Is it right? Now my question is, what is the total cash paid on redemption? What is the total cash paid on redemption? Anybody, any guesswork? Total cash paid on redemption in rupees? Huh? 26 lakh? No, that's too less. 89 lakh? 89,25,000. This 25,000 will get full cash. Out of 75, 15 got converted into shares. For remaining 60, you have to pay cash. So 25, they will not get any share, so they want cash only. And this 60,000. So total on 85,000 debenture, or you can just understand 1 lakh minus 15,000. On 85,000 debenture, you have to pay cash at the rate of 105. So how much it comes to? Right. So what is the question? We are discussing so many things, but I need to know what is the question. Investments were realized at par on sale. So you'll sell the investment of 15 lakh rupees. Bank account debit to DRR investment. No profit, no loss on sale. All the transactions were put through without any lag on 1st July 2021. Wow, Superman. On one day they have completed everything. They sold the investment, they redeemed the debenture, they converted into equity share. So now the question is, redraft the balance sheet of the company. On 1st July, after giving effect to the redemption, show your calculation. You have to prepare working note. Show your calculation in respect of number of equity shares to be allotted. One working note they have specifically asked you to prepare, and the necessary cash payment. So whatever we discussed, we have to put that in the paper. Plus this time, you don't have to pass entry. You have to directly prepare the, by visualizing the effect on each and every item of the balance sheet, you have to prepare the balance sheet. In case if you are confused, then maybe in rough you can pass journal entry and then prepare the balance sheet. Okay. So first we'll prepare at least these two working notes. Write down step one. Step number one, which is your question in the given case study, that you have to calculate the number of equity shares to be allotted. Calculation of number of equity shares to be allotted. Calculation of number of equity shares to be allotted. Calculation of number of equity shares to be allotted. Right hand side, write down numbers. All figures are in numbers. wherever rupees will be there, we'll write rupees. Okay. First, write point A. What is point A? Total number of debentures, which is 1 lakh. Total number of debentures, write 1 lakh. Then write down, less not opted for conversion. Less not opted for conversion. So those who are holding 25,000 debenture, they said simply we don't want any equity shares. Okay. So therefore, point C, therefore debentures, debenture holders opted for conversion. So those who are holding 75,000 debenture, they said we will go for conversion, whatever maximum we can convert. But the company said you can only convert 20%, not everything. So point number D, write down. Option for conversion 20%. Option for conversion is 20%. Option for conversion is 20%. Those who want 20% equity share, they can be issued equity share. Point E, write down. Number of debentures to be converted. Number of debentures to be converted. C into D. Write neatly. Number of debentures to be converted. C multiplied by D. What is the answer? 15,000. Point F, write down. Redemption value per debenture. Redemption value per debenture. Redemption value per debenture. 100 rupees plus 5% premium. So what is the total value of equity share to be issued? Point number G, redemption value of 15,000 debentures. Redemption value of 15,000 debentures. 15,000 multiplied by 105. So company has to pay 15,75,000 rupees on these debentures which are converted into share. But instead of paying in cash, they want to pay in the form of shares. So then I have to divide by issue price of equity share. Point number H. Issue price per equity share. Issue price per equity share. Write in bracket given. Write in bracket given. 15.75. Is right? So what is the last line for this working note? Number of equity shares to be issued. Number of equity shares to be issued. G upon H. 1 lakh. Number of equity share to be issued is G upon H, 1 lakh, right? So this way you can write the answer in the exam also neatly with all presentation. If you issue 1 lakh share, your number of equity share will increase by 1 lakh. So in the given balance sheet to you, tick mark equity share capital. Tick mark equity share capital, which is right now 5 lakh. You make it in pencil plus 1 lakh. So that 5 lakh will become 6 lakh. And you also just write in pencil, securities premium will also appear. Because your share price is 15.75. Face value is 10. So 1 lakh into 5.75 will appear as securities premium. So securities premium will appear. Okay. Then next working note 2, write down step 2. Calculation of cash to be paid. Right. Calculation of cash to be paid. Calculation of cash to be paid. This is a specific question also. राइट हैंड साइड अमाउंट. हाउ टू कैलकुलेट हाउ मच कैश हैज टू बी पेड. पॉइंट ए राइट टोटल नंबर ऑफ डिबेंचर्स. देर आर टू वेज यू कैन डू. आइदर यू कैन टेक 1 lakh माइनस 15,000 और 25,000 प्लस 60,000. 25,000 प्लस दिस आई थिंक इज सिंपल. टोटल नंबर ऑफ डिबेंचर इन द बैलेंस शीट 1 lakh. टोटल नंबर ऑफ डिबेंचर इन द बैलेंस शीट लेस नंबर ऑफ डिबेंचर्स टू बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू शेयर. लेस नंबर ऑफ डिबेंचर टू बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू शेयर. इन ब्रैकेट राइट स्टेप 1. वट इज द सोर्स ऑफ दिस 15,000. स्टेप 1. गो टू स्टेप 1. यू विल फाइंड 15,000 देयर. इज इट देयर? इज इट देयर? यस. सो 15,000 डिबेंचर्स विल गेट कन्वर्टेड इन टू इक्विटी शेयर. फॉर रिमेनिंग यू हैव टू पे कैश. सो राइट बैलेंस ए माइनस बी 85,000. एंड हाउ मच अमाउंट इज पेबल पर शेयर पर डिबेंचर 105. सो राइट रिडम्पशन वैल्यू पर डिबेंचर. राइट इन डिटेल एवरीथिंग. रिडम्पशन वैल्यू पर डिबेंचर 105. एनी क्वेरी? नो. सो व्हाट इज द टोटल कैश पेड? राइट डाउन रिडम्पशन वैल्यू ऑफ 85,000 डिबेंचर सी इन टू डी. रिडम्पशन वैल्यू ऑफ 85,000 डिबेंचर्स C into D. Multiply C 85,000 D 105. You will get 89,25,000. So this much cash has to be paid. Now I am going to ask you one more simple question. Before we prepare the balance sheet, what will be the cash balance in the balance sheet after you complete your transaction? Cash and bank that will appear in your balance sheet. Try. 75,000 only. That's it. 75 lakh is opening balance. Plus you are going to redeem that investment, DRR investment at par, 15 lakh. And then you are going to redeem this 89.25. So you'll be left with, so to visualize that my DRR investment will be sold, debenture will be redeemed, and we are left with only 75,000. Once again, opening balance 75 lakh, DRR investment realized 15 lakh, redemption of debenture in cash 89 lakh, 25,000. So balance left is 75,000. Balance left is 75,000. Write one working note for that also. Calculation of cash and bank balance. Step 3. Calculation of cash and bank balance. Step 3. Step 3. Calculation of cash and bank balance. It is better to prepare this working note. It has two adjustments. So cash and bank balance will change. DRR investment will not appear in the balance sheet anymore. DRR will also not appear. General reserve tick mark, that will change. Because DRR balance will be transferred to general reserve. Share capital will change, that we have discussed. Securities premium will appear in the balance sheet. Debentures will not appear anymore. Add DRR investment sold. Add DRR investment sold. Now read the problem. It says investments were realized at par on sale. Now in this question it is same 15 lakh. In your exam they may say investments will be sold at 10% profit. So then you will take 15 lakh plus 10%. Okay. and that profit you will also add to the P&L account. So your P&L account will also get affected. Then write down less amount paid to debenture holders. Less amount paid to debenture holders. 89,25,000. As per step 2. Therefore, cash and bank balance. Therefore, cash and bank balance. 75,000. So now I can directly prepare the balance sheet. Equity share capital will change. General reserve will change. Okay. P&L account balance will also change. Why? P&L account balance will change. Question is why? We have to pay premium on redemption of debenture. So for that I will have to debit P&L account. DRR balance will be transferred to general reserve. Convertible debentures will be redeemed. It won't appear. Other loan will appear. Current liability will appear as it is. Fixed asset will appear as it is. DRR investment we have sold. Cash balance we have computed 75,000. And other current asset will appear as it is. Is it right? Say yes. Awaaz nahi aayi?
Yes.
Okay. Write the balance sheet format first. As per this question, this will be the balance sheet. Balance sheet of Convertible Limited as on 1st July 2021. This time the problem says everything got completed on 1st of July. Serial number, particulars, note number, rupees. Serial number, particulars, note number, rupees. First write down part 1, equity and liabilities. Part 1, equity and liabilities. This is part 1. Now under that point 1, this is numbering system. Point 1, shareholders funds. You have to present in Schedule 3 format. Under that we have two numbers. A, share capital. So much details are there. We will write in note number 1. Then B, reserve and surplus. Note number 2. Then write down in serial number column point number 2. Non-current liabilities. Under non-current liabilities, you write down long-term borrowing. Which item will come under this head? That other loans. In your question, there is other loans. So that will come here. Now, we don't know whether it is secured or unsecured, so I am not writing. Is it right? Otherwise, you have to also write secured or unsecured. Then you write down point number 3. This is point number 3, current liabilities. Nowadays, we don't write current liabilities and provision. We only write current liabilities. Further breakup of current liabilities are not available. So, just current liabilities. Total. One line blank. Point number 2. What is point number 2? Assets. Second part is assets. Write down neatly. 1. Non-current assets. Under that A. Property, plant and equipment. Under that Roman 1. Tangible asset. One line blank. Point number 2. Written. Current assets. In current asset, two items only I'll write this time. One is cash and cash equivalent. Cash and cash equivalent. No need to write note because already we have calculated. Cash and cash equivalents. And point two, write down other current asset total. Other current assets total. Any query? Same question presented in Schedule 3 format. All of you have noted the balance sheet format. Any query? Those who have completed this format, write down below this balance sheet notes to accounts. Notes to accounts. Two notes will prepare. Notes to account. Note number, particulars, rupees, rupees. Note number, particulars, rupees, rupees. Note number, first this column will be note number, particulars, rupees, rupees. Note number one, right? Share capital authorized. Check whether authorized capital is given in this problem. Not given, then you write like this, dash dash equity shares of rupees 10 each. It's not given this time, we don't know exact number. Dash dash double underline issued, subscribed and paid up. Issued, subscribed and paid up. 5 lakh shares are already there, 5 lakh plus 1 lakh shares issued to debenture holder. So total we have 6 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 each fully paid. Is it right? So how much it will come to? 60 lakh? Write 60 lakh. Write a note below. Note, out of above, 1 lakh shares of rupees 10 each, fully paid. Out of above, 1 lakh shares of rupees 10 each fully paid were issued on conversion of debentures. Were issued on conversion of debentures. Were issued on conversion of debentures. Note has to be written when you are issuing equity share and not receiving any cash for that. So that note will be written as per Schedule 3. So come to main page. Write down share capital 60 lakh. Note number 1, share capital 60 lakh. Written main page, share capital 60 lakh. Then note number 2, write down reserves and surplus. Don't talk, just 2 minutes. Note number 2, reserves and surplus. Under that we will write a profit and loss account. A profit and loss account dash opening balance. Anybody, what is the opening balance of profit and loss account? Go to the balance sheet. Is it 10 lakh? In this question, you are issuing, redeeming debenture at a premium. So that premium will be debited to P&L account. So you have to visualize that this premium paid on redemption of debenture will be debited to P&L account. Less premium on redemption of debenture. Less premium on redemption of debenture. Is it 5 lakh? 1 lakh into 5? 1 lakh debenture into 5 rupees premium. So your P&L account balance left will be 5 lakh. Somebody said DRR. No need to transfer to DRR anymore. It's already transferred. It's already. So now in this working note, we will not transfer from P&L account to DRR. It's already there in the balance sheet. Is it right? You don't have to remember the answer. Every answer is different. Previous problem, we were passing the entry. This time the entry has been passed before us. Point number B. General reserve. Opening balance. What is opening balance of general reserve? 90 lakh. Is it 90 lakh? And at transfer from DRR, how much is that? 10 lakh. 10 lakh. So what is the total? 1 crore. Now, securities premium write down. Don't forget we have issued 1 lakh equity share at a premium of 5 rupees 75. How much is that? 5,25,000. Total is how much? 1 crore 10 lakh 75,000. 110,75,000. Can we go to the main page now? 1 crore 10 lakh 75,000 written. Yes. Very good. Come on. 1 crore 10 lakh 75,000. Outer column. 1 crore 70 lakh. What is the other loans in the balance sheet? 65 lakh. What is current liability in the balance sheet? 1 crore, same figure, copy. Keep question in front of you. Copy the figures. Tell me the total of liability side now. 3 crore 60 lakh 75,000. Check. Is it right? Property, plant, equipment, tangible asset, same figure. 1 crore 60 lakh. Cash and cash equivalent. Other current asset, so total is how much? 2 crore 75 lakh. Okay, 75,000. Now what is the asset side total? 3 crore 60 lakh 75,000. Tallied. This answer is over. Now we'll continue on Monday. So today what you do, try the balance question as homework.